Hey there everyone, welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So today we're going to be doing a ghost effect, as you can see in the example here. So we're using Blender 2.8, but this can be done in Blender 2.7. There may just be a few little differences when it comes to the process, but essentially the compositing and the masking, it will be the same. So if you want to follow along in Blender 2.79 or Blender 2.8, it's entirely up to you. If you do want to download 2.8, just remember it is in beta, so there may still be some problems. Just keep that in mind. Anyway, so let's go ahead and choose the workspace that we want to work with. So you can use the general, which would be this one here. But I'm going to use the VFX workspace, so I'm going to go ahead and click this. Now we have this, we can get rid of a couple of windows, we don't need these two, so I'm just going to right click up here, join area, and just make sure I join it this way. Same thing for this, there we go. So let's go ahead and open up the movie clip, so up here we can click open. So this is the movie clip that I'm working with, and if you want to use this too, I'll throw a link in the description. So the first thing we need to do is go ahead and set the scene frames. Right now it's at 250. I'm going to set this to 200, but if you want, you can go over here to the set scene frames button, click this, and it'll set it to the maximum amount of frames. Now we've set the scene frames, let's go over to the prefetch button and click this. We'll see that this purple bar will fill up. If it doesn't fill up all the way, you will need to go to edit, then preferences, then system. Then you'll need to find the memory cache limit or the sequencer cache limit and just increase this. Then you can go ahead and save your settings and you won't need to worry about that again. Then you can go ahead and prefetch and it should fill up all the way. I'm going to scrub through this movie clip and see what we're working with. So this shot is pretty interesting. We've got this couple here sat in front of a nice view. And it's kind of a nice little coupley scene, I guess. They're in love. But let's go ahead and flip this. Let's say this guy is sad and lonely. He's lost a loved one, which is going to be this woman here. So we're going to turn this woman into a ghost. And now when we play through, we can see she doesn't really move that much. So we're going to need to create a mask for this woman. Now we don't need this tracking section, so we could either press tab and go to the masking mode, or up here click this. Or we could use the masking section, which is dedicated just to masking. Again, we would need to tidy this up and get rid of these. So it's entirely up to you which way around you do it. I'm just going to do it like this. So now we're in the masking mode, select this movie clip icon, select our movie clip, and we can go ahead and create the mask. So I'm going to click new, I'm going to call this woman, control left click, and then I'm going to get a little bit closer to her body here. And again, I'm going to come back and tidy this up. Something like this, just hold control and keep left clicking around, trace around the shape, and then sharp points like this, you can always come back and refine a little bit later on. Then hold Alt and then press C just to close this mask. Now you want to play through and make sure the woman doesn't go past the edges of this mask, so let's just increase this, just scroll through this, that's pretty good. Again, you might want to animate the mask as well, so when this arm moves very slightly, you might want to animate these. Just and to do that, if we jump to the first frame, then click this button here, press A to select all of them, then press G, then hit enter. That's just added a keyframe for all of these. Then you just want to scrub through and then keep moving these points around. Just since we have this button enabled, it will automatically save or record the movements that you make, so go ahead and do that. Now I'm happy with this, so I'm going to move on to the compositing. For this, we just need to check use nodes. And then we have the render layers and the composite node, so let's go ahead and delete the render layers. So you can either press X to delete it, or if you've got the node wrangler add-on, just hold shift and then press S, then we can actually switch the type. I'm going to switch this to a movie clip. Now I can go ahead and click this movie clip icon. Now we can see it's updated here, but we don't have a preview, so let's go ahead and add a viewer node. Hold Control, Shift, and left click on this movie clip. It'll just add a viewer node for us. This effect is very, very simple. It's essentially two mix nodes. So let's Shift A, go to Color, Mix. I'm going to drop this in here. Shift A, go to Input, add a mask. I'll go ahead and select the woman mask. Plug this into the factor. something like this. Now what we can do is just plug this image into this one, and we have this. So this is kind of similar to the very last tutorial we did where we patched over a few things. The only difference is we don't actually need to control the mask on this one, so a little bit different. That's why I didn't append in the patch node, which I could have. If you guys followed the previous tutorial, you'll know what I'm talking about. So now we have this, Shift A, down to distort, then transform. I'm going to drop this on the bottom string. Then what I'm going to do is just move this on the X. As soon as we do that, we can see the woman starts to disappear. Like this. And also I'm going to change the angle, just so it kind of lines up. So now we have this, which it's kind of adding that fake background, which is good. Now what we need to do is just go to this mix node, Shift D to duplicate it, and then we can drop it on right after. So now what we can do is, if I take this mask here, plug this into the factor, use the same mask, we get this again. Now what I want to do is plug in this original background image into this open slot, and we get this. So now it looks exactly the same as it did in the beginning. If I preview this by clicking this and plugging it into the viewer node, then we add the background, then we've added the image back on top. So now we just need to add one more node just to make her a bit more ghost-like. So Shift A, go to Converter, then to Color Ramp. I'll drop this on the string here where the mask goes into the factor of this second mix node. Then what we can do, if we select this white handle here, then select this color, and then start to drag this down. Now the more we do this, the more see-through she becomes, the more ghost-like. Then the final touch we can add is a little bit of blur to these edges. So I want these to be two different values, that's why I'm adding two different blurs. So Shift A, go to Filter, then to Blur, just drop this in here. Shift D, drop it in here. Now for this one, it's going to be a small amount, maybe 10. And then for this one, maybe 20, gives a nice soft edge. So I'm going to select both of these and then press M to mute it, just so you can see the difference before and after. So this is with the blur and this is without the blur. So if we zoom in, we can see it's very harsh and horrible. With the blur, looks a lot better. Looks like, make sure you refine your masks. But now I think that looks pretty good. Again, you can always add some more effects. Maybe you're happy with this and you want to render it out, we just need to go over here to output. Let's make sure that the video resolution is the same as the movie clip. You also want to make sure that this is at 100. We go down to where it says output. Let's select a location to save this to. Then go down to file format. Change this from PNG to an FFmpeg video. Then here in encoding, we just want to select this icon. And then we can choose H.264 in MP4 format. Now we've done that, we can see it's changed. Let's go over here to the render. Now the display mode. I just want to change this to image editor just so it doesn't pop out into a new window. Then we can go to render and render the animation, or use the shortcut, which is Control F12. Go ahead and render it out. So you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, be sure to give this a like. Also, be sure to check out our blog. As always, thank you for watching and see you next time.